Hello, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today's topic of discussion is the invention of vitamin C. So the history of vitamin C is actually very interesting. You may have heard about it, but before we get into that, thank you for joining me today. Be sure to give me a big thumbs up at the end of this video, and make sure that you're subscribed and you turn on your notifications so you always get my newest and latest upload, and share this information with someone that you believe will benefit from this wonderful natural information all about vitamin C. So the history goes back into the European ships that were coming over from Europe over to North America between the 16th and 18th century. And something called scurvy, so a lack of vitamin C, it was discovered, killed more than 2 million sailors. And it wasn't until 1753 that a Scottish naval surgeon named James Lind actually discovered that if the sailors consumed lemons and the juice of lemons, that they didn't get the symptoms of scurvy, nor did they die. So it actually saved their lives. What's interesting is that humans don't make vitamin C. We're one of the few animals that don't make vitamin C, including guinea pigs and apes as well. And that's because we actually lack a special enzyme called L-glonolactone oxidase enzyme. And that's critical for the last step of vitamin C synthesis. It was discovered in 1930, and Albert St. Germain actually won the Nobel Prize for this because he discovered that it was possible to isolate ascorbic acid from red peppers. Now, what's really interesting to note here is that he actually published in his paper that ascorbic acid wasn't bioavailable or active when removed from the red pepper. So what that means is that the body's ability to utilize that vitamin C was compromised when it was not in the whole food form of the red pepper. And that's something that I always talk about getting our vitamins and minerals from whole food sources is always the best way to do it, as Mother Nature intended. So, how do northern cultures get their vitamin C? Well, that was a question that I had in my own mind, because if you think about it, the further north that you go from the equator, and certainly in, you know, cultures when eating their native diets, if you think of the Inuit, they, you know, had relatively no access to fresh fruits and vegetables in that harsh Arctic environment. So how did they get their vitamin C? Well, there's something called muktuk, and this was actually from the whale skin and the fat of a beluga whale. Also, some seafood and fish, their internal organ meat, contains natural vitamin C, which humans, of course, can use. So that's how historically, now whether they still follow their cultural diet, you know, without having the North American or other parts of the world influence on their diet, because now, of course, we can ship food in, but those eating their traditional Inuit diet get the vitamin C from those sources, from the sea, which of course is very interesting. So thanks for joining me today. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today we talked all about the invention of vitamin C and some interesting tidbit facts about vitamin C. Be sure to give me a big thumbs up and share this video with those of you who think will benefit from this information. Also, be sure to always take care of your good health and do it naturally.